Welcome to the second part of the lesson, Respiration. The topics covered in this part are events of respiration, breathing, pathway of air, and role of epiglottis. Moving into the events of respiration, there are no certain demarcations that these are the events in the process of respiration. As respiration is a very complex process and involves many biochemical and physical pathways, we can just understand the process under certain headings like breathing, gaseous exchange at lung level, gas transport by blood, gaseous exchange at tissue level, and cellular respiration. So the air which goes into our body is taken by the lungs. From the lungs it goes to the units of lungs called alveoli. From the alveoli the blood uptakes the gas and it transports to the different cells of the body. Different cells of the body uptake the oxygen and they use the oxygen to produce the energy from the food material what is present in the cell. To understand the first step, that is breathing, we can perform a small activity like taking two flasks and pouring lime water in the flask. So when you continuously perform the activity of breathing, like taking in air and giving out air, when you give out the air, the lime water which is present in the flasks will turn into milky. Thereby, it indicates that the exhaled air contains carbon dioxide. So let us know some facts on respiratory organs of the human body. A person usually breathes an average of 13 pints of air every minute. And if you take the lungs, they are not in the same size. The left lung is little bit smaller than the right lung to give space to the heart. And lungs and tennis court can be the same size. That means when you spread the inner parts of the lungs, it can cover nearly 160 meters square of area, which is equal to a tennis court. And as usual, we know oxygen plays a major role in breathing, but only a small part. And 70% of waste is eliminated through our lungs just by simple breathing. Children and women breathe faster. And humans exhale up to 17.5 milliliters of water per hour in the form of water vapor. From the above activity, we have understood that the gas coming out from the body turns lime water milky. That means the exhaled air consists of more amounts of carbon dioxide. And apart from that, our exhaled air also consists of water vapor which is released out. So regarding this, in the lower classes you have learnt an activity like blowing air on a surface of the mirror. So when you blow air on the surface of a mirror, whatever water vapor is present in our exhaled air touches the cool surface of the mirror and turns into water droplets. That means you can see the water droplets on the mirror. So by this we can conclude that our exhaled air consists of carbon dioxide and water vapor. The process of respiration is performed by an organ system in our body called as respiratory system. So this respiratory system consists of different parts called lungs, and lungs are still divided into sac-like structures called alveoli, where the gaseous exchange happens. So to understand this, we shall go deep into the topic knowing what is the pathway of air in our body. Let's have a closer look of human respiratory system. The parts in human respiratory system are nasal cavity, pharynx, larynx, trachea. Trachea divided into two branches called bronchus, and bronchus is still divided into smaller branches called bronchioles. and there are one pair of lungs, right lung and left lung, and the inner parts of the lungs are still divided into smaller subunits called alveoli. So if you see the pathway of air, air enters into our body through nostrils. So when we inhale the air, it goes into the nostrils and then goes into the nasal cavity. Here, the inner lining of the nasal cavity is moist and contains hair. The moistness and hair present in the nasal cavity helps the air to filter and removes the dust particles or bacteria present in the air. And also, it brings the temperature of the air close to the body temperature. Then, the air moves into the pharynx. Here, the pharynx is a common passage for air and food. Here, there is a flap-like structure which regulates the movement of air and food into their respective passages, that is epiglottis. So by the help of epiglottis, the air enters into the next part, that is larynx. From larynx, goes into trachea, bronchus, then goes into the bronchioles and distributed in the whole lungs. And in the lungs, the alveoli takes the oxygen and it exchanges the oxygen with blood. And the blood takes the oxygen, transports it to different cells which are present in the whole body. There the cell utilizes the oxygen and releases the carbon dioxide again into the blood. So whatever carbon dioxide is released by the cell, the blood brings back to the alveoli. There again the gaseous exchange happens and the carbon dioxide in the vice versa process, that is in the opposite direction, from the alveolus goes to bronchioles, from bronchioles to bronchus, trachea, larynx, pharynx and nasal cavity, and finally is expelled out from the body through nostrils. As we have discussed before, there is a common passage for both food and air in the throat region, that is in the pharynx. So there is a very tricky process how the air and food are regulated to their respective passages. So the major role is played by the epiglottis, which is present in the pharynx area. So as you can see here, the food is directed towards the esophagus, that is commonly we call food pipe, by a valve-like structure called epiglottis. So this epiglottis acts like a valve and partially closes the pharynx when we swallow the food. So by this, it regulates the movement of air and food and helps the food to pass properly into the esophagus. This is the end of part 2. We shall discuss the next topics like mechanism of respiration and related topics in the next videos. Thank you.